Amazing story coming up next on The Jeff Krille Show.
Many are predicting that the worst is yet to come, which is unfortunate, said one person here. Until now, they've enjoyed the reputation of being the nation's icebox.
Watched a burglar in his home this morning by webcam.
As a journalist of over 25 years, stories are what make my world turn.
Reporting live from the Dallas newsroom tonight, Jeff Krille, Fox 4 News.
But in 2008, I took the jump from my familiar life and started a PR firm from my home.
We're talking about anyone with a camcorder like the one I'm using becomes a television network.
We started slowly growing the company, and we now have over 100 clients, and we've branched into the world of live digital broadcasting. I now own 8 different TV studios and have a huge team, and the stories that I now get to share are sometimes the most important of my life. Life has a funny way of coming around full circle. This is The Jeff Krille Show.
Welcome to The Jeff Krille Show. I'm Dallas Krille, filling in for my dad today. Dad, hope I make you proud. And it's also a very special day because it's my grandpa's birthday today. So we have 3 generations of Krille going on here. It's going to be a great show today. We're joined here with Lenard Myers, celebrity barber, athlete, and model.
Yes, sir.
A man who does a little bit of everything and does it well. Welcome to the show.
Yes, sir. Thank you for having me. I'm blessed to be here.
Awesome. Well, I'm looking forward to hearing more about your story.
Yes, sir.
Before you tell it in your own words, we have a really cool video that I was watching that shares a little bit of it from a professional perspective.
Yes,
let's
sir.
Go ahead and play that video.
My first celebrity, quote unquote, client that I ever cut was my boy Jamil Showers. He had saw on Instagram, I guess it popped up as the friends you may know, because I had just remade my page to let people know that I was a mobile barber. So he hit me up and was like, bro, you in Dallas? I'm like, yeah. He's like, bro, you gotta come cut me. I said, say less. So I put up on him, cut his hair. He's like, bro, I gotta get a cut from you every week. I said, I got you. I said, bro, listen, if you tell your teammates about me and they come get a cut, every time they come, you get a free haircut. And it was a domino effect from there. My name is Lenard Myers, and this is my story. Man, 2 days at Tarzan State University, amazing. It was one of those things where it was my first time in college, I didn't know what to expect, and everything was just like so new and exciting. Everybody was looking rough by the head. We had photo shoots for picture day. So I got this bright idea to tell everybody I know how to cut hair, knowing that I didn't. So my first customer was like, hey man, you know how to cut? I'm like, yeah, I got you. So I went home, watched a YouTube video on the hairstyle that he wanted, and started cutting. So he got out of the chair, looked at it. He was like, oh, this is pretty good. And I'm looking at him, I'm looking at myself in the mirror. I'm like, you like it? He's like, yeah, man, this dope. I said, uh-oh, I might be onto something here. So I had declared for the draft already. Found out I was gonna have to have knee surgery. Did that. So now I'm in this dark place in my life to where I'm trying to beat my body. My family and friends are kind of like looking at me as like the golden ticket, you know, out the hood. I've been through a lot so early that I was able to understand that like life goes on. So I decided in life that I just gotta ride the wave. And waves, as you know, they go up and down. So whenever you're going up, everything's going good. The moment you go down, you gotta learn how to work through the down phases in order for you to go back up so you can enjoy the good again. And so that's what I looked at it as. And so football, everything just happened so fast for me, the success of it. And it kind of like caught me off guard because I was trying to do everything for my team instead of for myself. The reason why I go so hard is because I came from nothing. But I was blessed with a beautiful mom who gave me the mindset of taking advantage of the small things first and then the big things are gonna fall in line. And so just me being brought up like that, every opportunity I got, I would take advantage of it. Just to show people that you can come from anything and still, you know, be on top.
If it wasn't for them, it wouldn't be no me. What you finna see next, just be ready, because God is good.
Oh yeah, that's better than good.
Wow, that's amazing. You're
yes,
amazing.
Sir.
So I want to hear it from your own words.
Yes,
bring
sir.
Us back to the early days from the beginning and bring us to where you are now. Tell us your story.
So a little bit about my story, just a quick brief. I grew up in a single parent home. My mother, she was blessed with five beautiful kids, four girls and one boy. Of course, I'm the only boy. And so I had to become man of the house very early. Where we grew up at, the crime rate was really high. A lot of drugs, drug violence, gangs and all of that. So my mom did the best she could to keep me active in sports. And same thing with my sisters and school activities. Fast forward to me being some kind of star out of nowhere, just blessed with the genetics from my mom and my dad. They were athletes as well. My mom, she played basketball, volleyball, ran track. My dad played basketball, but I don't know him, but thank you, Dad. So I was able to, my mom raised a great young man, very respectful, treat people like I want to be treated. You know, that was like our golden rule in the house. And so with that being said, I was able to prosper a lot further than I was supposed to based off of, you know, how I started.
Absolutely.
And so with that being said, it was just one of those things where I just take advantage of every opportunity the best way instead of trying to making people feel used. So now I went to college, was blessed with the opportunity to do really well school-wise and also performance-wise on the field. And that brought me to Dallas. I had knee surgery. My agent had me at MJP training in Frisco, or McKinney. And I was in a dark place at that time because I know that I can perform, but due to my knee injury, it had like a dark cloud over my head. Mm. And so mentally, I was losing this battle because I'm mind over body 100%. Mm-hmm. My mind was there, but my body, I couldn't move my leg. So I told my agent, I was like, hey, I need time off just so I can get my mental back right. With that time being off, I was able to tap into finding my purpose in life and how I can still serve people. And so that's how the celebrity barber thing started. So I started marketing to the higher ups, celebrities, business owners. And the way that I started doing that was, as you've seen in the video, one of the guys I was training with, Jamil Showers, he played for the Cowboys. He was Tony Romo's backup at the time. He found out I was in Dallas. He hit me up and was like, you in Dallas? I'm like, yeah. Are you still cutting? And then everything was history from there. The domino effect, me being a genuine person, people seeing me for who I am, and God just showed out from there. So now I'm here. I'm blessed to be here.
That's amazing.
Yes, sir.
That's amazing. So you do some great haircuts. I want to make sure that we show those in a second. But first, I want to talk a little bit more about, I'm fascinated by the fact that you're so good at so many different things.
Yes, sir.
I mean, you got extremely far in your athletics, mm-hmm. and now you've gone extremely far in your barber business.
Right.
You're very multi-talented. What would you attribute that to?
Really just seeing my mom growing up. She had to work with five different kids' schedules. None of us was the same age. So with her having to work, drop this kid off at school, pick this kid up, take this kid here, take this kid there, and also still make food for us at nighttime when it's time, you know, make sure every kid is showered, getting our clothes ready for the next day. I'm seeing her multitask throughout my whole entire life. Not one tear shed at all.
Wow.
Strong woman.
Wow.
So I see her doing that. I'm like, I gotta match my mom's tempo, if not better. Like, I'm a man. You know, she helped make sure that I would be the man that she wanted me to be. And then by taking that, me having these father figures and role models in my life, me taking bits and pieces from them to become more, you know, of a manly man. And now I'm just here. I'm like, if she can do it, I can do it. That's my mom.
Absolutely.
Like, I came from her.
Shout out to Mrs. Myers.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yes,
tell me about some of the male role models in your life and how they've shaped you.
So I would say first and foremost, I call him Dad, Myron Ridge. Man, he's a great guy. He was a police officer at the time. He had three or four different businesses. He owned like six or seven rent houses. And he was just like this strong role model that helped you understand business. Mm. So then go forward to me going to high school. I was transitioning from middle school to high school. I was running AAU track. Ronald Ford, shout out to Ronald Ford. He was a very important part of my high school career. I didn't want to go to high school at the town that I was in because my cousin was looked at as like the face of Temple, Texas at that time. He was the number one running back in the nation. and I was a year behind him. And I was doing my thing too, but I was overshadowed by him. I didn't want to be in his shadows no more. So me and him, me and Ronald Ford would have talks. I call him dad as well, pops. We would have talks, and he was like, well, we could figure out something because I know you don't want to be in the shadow. Went to a different high school, and my light started shining from there because the shadow was gone.
Wow.
So then also in high school, one of my, was my freshman basketball coach, Shay Diffie, amazing guy, amazing. Just for me watching him go eat with his family, meeting his family, him being that guy that just like understands or like that's willing to understand, whole different perspective. So I literally got these three or four different role models that I'm learning from, different perspectives, different way of life. And I literally took bits and pieces from them and made them part of me.
All the best, all the different styles of Kung Fu.
Yes.
And it's amazing how really we become a combination of some of the most important people in our lives, where in each one we recognize something that we admire and we're like, man, I want a little piece of that.
Yes, sir.
So yeah, very blessed.
Yes,
that's
sir.
Awesome. So why don't we show some of the haircuts that you've done? We have a before and after video. I love those because
yes,
you can see a dramatic difference.
Right.
Let's play that video.
Yes, sir.
Wow, that's awesome.
Thank
you. I'm a big believer in haircuts.
Yes, sir.
I believe that the right haircut can change your life.
Oh, absolutely.
Tell me some stories about some of your clients and what's one of the most dramatic ways that you've changed their style?
Man, honestly, it's one of those things that I love making people feel better about themselves. So for them to come to me with like this low energy, just like, you know, yeah, I'm here to get my hair cut, and then to leave with a whole different boost, like, I mean, I'm finna go do this, I'm finna go do that. No, they were just finna go right back home, but their confidence is back, they feel better about themselves, they look, they keep taking selfies, pictures.
Yeah.
I just really enjoy it. My craziest one by far, and I'm not gonna say his name because I love him, it's my guy. He came in, he took off his beanie, and it looked like it was like dry carpet or something on his head. I am not kidding.
Oh,
like,
I took it
off my Instagram because I was trying to like have the right theme going on.
Uh-huh.
But I would show the video, it would show his face, and I don't want to do that to him.
Yeah, yeah.
But that before and after was amazing. People was like, bro, what the, like, how do you do that?
The guy walks in, you're like, all right, I gotta take a picture
of
this.
No, literally, I did the before and after, and he just started laughing. He said, I already know you finna get me right, so I ain't worried about it. Did the after. Man, you can't tell him nothing.
That's amazing. Well, I really admire about how so much of you is you're determined to be a light in people's lives and to share your positivity with everyone. I was looking through your social media and you commonly post Bible verses.
Right.
You're not afraid to share your spirituality and share your light.
Right.
Tell me more about the influence that God has in your life.
A huge influence. I was brought up in a church, even though my mom might not have went, she made sure we stayed in church just so we can have a relationship with God. Just in, you know, she can't control everything and she can't see everything, but God can. You see what I'm saying?
Yep.
So she always instilled that in us at a young age. And shout out, Mom, I love you. So that just grew with me as I got older and older. And my grandmother, one thing she would always tell me, make sure you continue to pray. Even
Absolutely.
If I hadn't been to church in a while, make sure you continue to pray. Yes, ma'am. And so I'll catch myself sometime thinking I'm doing everything, and then God'll pull me back to reality and be like, hey, you need me. Oh, yes, sir, I'm sorry, God, let me pray.
Absolutely.
You know, thank you for life. Thank you for being able to breathe, smell. So that's like a huge part of me, but once again, I don't force that on nobody. Me doing what I do on social media is just venting out loud, in a sense. Because I'm not afraid to go around people and tell them, oh yeah, I believe in God. You know, I read the devotionals every day, I read scriptures every day. So this is just a way for me to feel more comfortable with who I am as a person. And if I'm able to touch somebody while I'm doing that, that's that the rest is on God.
Absolutely. You know?
So
yeah, and you're very authentic.
Yes, sir.
I don't know that the positivity message really works if you don't have that.
Exactly. So, mm.
Yeah, that's wonderful.
Yes, sir.
So let's move on to another one of your specializations. You are a model.
Yes, sir.
And you were telling me before the show you were surprised to find that you were voted the best model in Dallas 2020 in the Dallas Observer.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell us more about your modeling career.
Yes, sir. So first and foremost, I'm still shocked that that's even a thing like right now.
And
like,
he's humble too.
Man, no, I swear, like it's so crazy. Cause my agent, I woke up one morning, he sent it to me and I was like, why this got my name on here? And he was like, yeah, you won. I was like, so I'm reading, I'm like, it sounds like me, but I don't, is this me?
That's amazing.
You know, so very thankful. Dallas Observer, thank you guys so much. So funny story behind the modeling stuff. So I'm in Dallas, I'm starting my my mobile business. This guy keeps DMing me on Instagram about being a model, mm-hmm. right? I don't know who this guy is, never met him before. I'm like, well, I don't think I'm a model. I don't want a model, I'm okay. 3 months go by. Like clockwork, he's still DMing me, asking me about doing different shows, da da da. And I'm like, why does dude keep hitting me up, right? So I go to the gym one day at Sanders Fit, and he's there. So I'm walking by him. Mind you, I don't know who he is, so I don't know what he looks like. He's like, hey, you Barb Bernardi? I'm like, oh yeah, what's up? And then he was like, hey, I'm the agent that's been DMing you on Instagram. I'm like, oh yeah, yeah. He was like, hey, I have this show, and I wanted to know if you wanted to come check it out so you can see maybe if you wanted to do something in the future. So I'm like, okay, yeah, I'm gonna let you know. So I try to walk off. He's like, oh, I don't have your number. I'm like, okay, cool. So I gave him my number. He takes me the information. I didn't respond. So my best friend, he was like, man, I told him about the situation that happened at the gym. He's like, you really need to try modeling. And I was like, bro, why? I'm not a model. He said, bro, with the body that you got and the look you have, I would have like 10 kids. I was like, bro, you crazy. He was telling me, he was saying, man, you do it, you say you did it, and if nothing comes of it. If you do it and something does come, you'll be happy you tried. So I'm like, all right, you know what, you're right. So then I messaged the modeling guy back, did my first show at the Ritz-Carlton, and it was history from there.
Wow.
And to be clear.
And now you're the best.
No, I'm the best. I'm not the best. But to be clear, the guy that I was ignoring is my agent.
Right now, to this day. Oh, wow. Yeah. Awesome.
So that same person is the one that was staying consistent with DMing me. That's my agent now.
Wow.
Amazing guy.
Wow. Crazy how just random things can totally put you on a new path.
Mm-hmm.
So
I was the crazy thing is I was trying to figure out how I can continue to level up with my barber business. Well, in barbering in general, you can only go so high, right?
Mm-hmm.
So as I was praying, God was sending me him, but I kept ignoring it. I was blocking
mm-hmm.
my blessing.
Mm-hmm.
Then the moment I was like, you know what? Let's see. And then each level started opening up. Other doors, and I'm just
that's
like,
how it works.
What? Yeah. I was trying to ignore this.
Yeah.
So it's crazy. I'm very thankful for him.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. So you look good for a living. You help people look good for a living.
Yes, sir.
And that brings us to the newest business venture that you're into.
Yes,
tell
sir.
Us about the pop-up shop. And I think it's an event this weekend, right?
Yes, sir. So Energy Check was a wellness check that I did on my social media to check on people in general. I'm a high energy person. My energy was very low this day. And I was like, man, if my energy low, I can only imagine other people. So I went to Instagram, had the right lighting. And I was like, energy check. Hey, man, I hope y'all having a great day. Just know that anything that you're going through right now is going to pass. So get ready, you know, for the aftermath. And there was just like a little hidden message. So I did that, got a lot of positive feedback. So then I had stopped for a minute. And people was like, hey, man, where my energy check at? They helped me get through the day last time you did it. And I'm like, what? Multiple people just saying different stuff, but saying that I needed to do it again.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, okay, cool. I got y'all. Don't worry about it. And that turned into me doing it consistently to help people be motivated instead of them complaining about the day. Oh, it's Monday. I got to go to work. And now they attack the day.
Yep.
They attack the day with the positivity that I start from me working out in the morning. I'm like, man, look, y'all better get in the gym.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get it. Just, you know, mm-hmm. just me being me. And it boosted them as well, on top of boosting myself. So then I got the bright idea for my agent to do t-shirts. So I did the t-shirts. Those went crazy. 100 orders a week, if not more.
Wow.
Every week. And so I'm like, I love the support. Like, yeah. You know, so I'm like, I didn't know I was really able, I didn't know I had this much love and support, even though I have a nice little amount of following on Instagram. But showing support and actually having support is like one and the same, but it's kind of different in my opinion. Like if you have a product and you tell your followers, hey, go buy this, mm-hmm. and all of them go buy it, you're yep. like, oh,
they actually show up
for you. Yeah, it's like they're very active.
Yeah.
You know, so, which leads me to the pop-up shop, October the 17th, from 2 to 6 p.m. at the center of Mockingbird Station. That there, I'll be releasing the fitness apparel for the women and the men, hats, hoodies, t-shirts, and it's going to be, the energy in the building is going to be so amazing that people are not going to want to leave. So that's why we extended it from 2 to 6. We could have did like a 2-hour, 3-hour, but we want people to feel important, like they matter. A lot of the who's who's going to be there. Some of my celebrity clients, celebrity friends, you know, the who's who. So you're going to get to rub shoulders with some important people that day if you come. If you don't come, I still appreciate you from afar. I know you're there in spirit. At the end of the day, this is just an energy check. This is,
I love it. I love it. All right. Well, we're running out of time here. Can you share with our audience where to find you online?
You can find me on social media at Barbara Nardi on Instagram. I have Snapchat, but I really don't get on it. Uh-huh. Just like my social media.
Uh-huh.
And I post a lot of stuff that I'm doing more often now because it's important, because mm-hmm. people see my story and they love to see my process. And if it wasn't for y'all, I wouldn't be posting nothing. So thank you guys. Huge shout out to y'all. But yes, I'm on social media at, on Instagram at Barbara Nardi.
Awesome. Awesome. Yes, thank you very much, Lenard. Yes, appreciate having you on the show. You want to end it with an energy check on three?
Yes, sir.
All right.
One, two, three.
Energy check.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
That's all for now.
Yes, sir.